So this house for me was an experiment. It was early in the kind of the days of CLT. It's from trees that have been killed by the beetle infestation. They can be smaller and narrower and shorter and from smaller, less valued trees. And so one of the advantages of this material is that you can take these pieces of wood out of the forest and then use them in ways that they couldn't be used because they're not as strong as the exterior two sides of this laminated panel. But they are strong enough to be a binder between those three panels. These 2x6s are going this way, and these ones are going that way, and then these ones are going that way. That's why it's called cross-laminated timber.
This building is one of the greenest buildings in the entire United States. By being able to do forest health treatment, where we go in and remove the dead, dying, diseased trees and turn it into building product, we're not only able to reduce carbon emissions from wildfires, but we're also able to sequester carbon in our buildings.
It's an amazing renewable product as well as being a product that embodies and stores carbon in its substance itself. One of the things that's been really exciting, as I mentioned in this whole journey of mass timber, has been the partnership with DNR and getting to know their priorities. And, you know, Hillary is an amazing communicator, and I think some of the strategic plans that she's put together, particularly her forest health strategic plan, to say how the need for healthy forests are really important, and also how CLT, by taking out smaller trees that have less market value, is a really win-win.
It's also an opportunity to create jobs in our rural communities that have been struggling for many generations. We're able to not only protect our forests and protect our state from wildfire, but we're also able to build a more greener built environment in our urban areas. Mm-hmm.